As someone who felt from a very young age, probably about the age of 5, that I knew what I wanted to do with my life, I have found the shift an incredible help for how I actually would like to live that life. It's one thing knowing what you want to do, and it's another thing understanding what you need to do to achieve that which you want.
The shift answers a lot of questions for me. And the amazing thing about the book is that it's not somebody telling you what to do or what not to do. It's about somebody's journey and the way through which he discovered himself and the things he did to move from life of misery to life of authenticity.
It doesn't tell you do this and this would happen. He used his own life's experience. He opened up himself, taught us what path he has taken to get to where he is. And I believe even if a reader would not take all those words to word, you'd always find something that intrigues.
What struck me first was a quotation in page 4, where Mo Issa, the writer, states, and I quote, that the quality of our lives depend on the quality of the questions we ask. And as you ask the questions, as you read this book, things begin to shift in your mind. Your thoughts begin to shift, your paradigms begin to shift, your models begin to shift. What you have taken as concepts and conceptions through your days of upbringing begin to shift.
What resonated with me most was early in Muhammad's book when he spoke about the power of your mind. It's something that I have noticed, a phenomenon. Your thoughts end up becoming things. And Muhammad very simply explains how everything we think about ends up materializing somehow in our lives. And it's just a message for all of us to be very careful about what we think, making sure that the thoughts that we want to materialize are reflected in the way that we are thinking and in the way that we are speaking.
I recommend this book for anybody who is threatened by midlife crisis, I want to call it, who got to a point in their lives where they can't find answers.
So for me, I came from that side, like the achievement, the success, and I wasn't that happy. I was okay. Now, it's completely different. I have this inner satisfaction. It's only through writing, reading and writing. When I say writing, I mean reading, because I see them as together. It's like something inside of me has awoken. Like, why didn't somebody tell me about it when I was 20?